With Charlotte, I'm not a songwriter, and I don't want to comment much on that because I feel like that's Zama's, you know, territory. But from a musical point of view, the beat that you hear on Charlotte is something that has been there for a year. And I was in Durban, Lady Zama was in Durban, and I told her about the song. We flew to Bloom. We got into my little bedroom studio. The song was recorded in like 40 minutes. And I mastered, I arranged the song, although there's some real lyrics in the song that I took out, you know. there's a part where Zama sings, there's a verse that I took out that I felt, you know, was not gonna make sense in the song, and the song worked as is, so yeah. The YOKINTO video is pretty simple. It's about a girl that is, you know, looking for attention, and the guy is busy with reflecting to the video. The guy is busy with cars, racing and whatever, and then eventually the last race, the girlfriend is racing with the guy, and she wins, and the guy notices, oh, it's the girl, and she's like, oh. Basically what the girl was trying to portray is that I can also be in your space as long as you can give me a chance to, you know, to be that person. Yeah, it's a bit complicated, I know, but you have a quick responsibility to me. Let me know if you cannot do the. How did Wajellwa come about? Okay, I call this other guy called Sean. He's a comedian and he's always talking shit. And he said, okay, cool, let's come up with a song called Wajellwa. I was like, okay, cool, let's do it. I'll do the beat, you do the lyrics. And he did the lyrics. The lyrical content of the song wasn't really that catchy. It didn't, you know, blow out of free state. And then we came with the guitar version and it was crazy. I remember my first gig out of Bloom was in Limpopo after I dropped Wajellwa. I played all these other songs. I played everything. I tried my level best. The crowd was like this until I dropped Wajellwa. It was crazy. That's when I knew what the song, you know, has made it.